Okay, I am Shantavion, and this is a new poem. It's not fully memorized, and this is titled Unspoken. I hate the way my voice sounds every time I speak into this microphone with it. How I imagined it in my head, thinking it's going to be different this time, or the next time, or the next time. Maybe never. But why not now? After being made fun of in the past, dude, you need to put some bass in your voice. Stop talking like that. Being asked, have you reached puberty yet? And it makes me wish my voice would change overnight to sound more like theirs. When I yelled, they could never take me seriously. And when I screamed, they're teasing, punching more than bee stings. You sound like a girl. I'm speechless. They will never listen to my pleas to be left alone. It was routine every day. Let's make this kid scream. It's funny. How is it funny to joke about others' disadvantages and misfortunes? It's a recipe for misery. They take it as enjoyment like a sitcom while I was on mute, then try to break me down to give me the squill. Then I would head home to watch Spoken Word while trying to digest these words that remain unsaid, my cries and my pleads. So I put them to page. Silence is the language I speak, translating through the simplest form of sign language, which is a simple nod, shake, or shrugging my shoulders. Say my breath for later instead of blowing smoke, going through one end and exit out the other. I'm sick of these tunnels, though it gives me hex when thoughts inflate like parachutes. But as Maya Angelou quoted, there is no greater agony than bearing an untold story inside of you. I can only explain through my knuckles the feelings breached through the freshly peeled scars as eggs and wounds. No questions, no comments, no closed mouths don't get fed. I'm already fed up. I still know it's no change. They keep coming at me. Just get out of my face. Just run along now and I'll go on home barricading myself behind my bedroom door. So sick of the self-hurt, so irritated with the teasing. Get your fingers out of my face and so tired of feeling so asphyxiated by the silence. We all have a say, but back then I didn't believe that. As I continue to pulverize my notebook, releasing inferior burdens, the words imprisoned until forgotten like distant memories, I've been told to just let them live. It is time to make changes on my own terms. Though I still suffer relapses like soldiers with post-traumatic stress, but still try to cultivate confidence as I slowly transform from an athlete to a poet. No longer a stranger to kindness because in Slam you all gave it and inspired me when I watch every clip. If I could, I would grip time and move it backwards so these moments will be everlasting. Caressed by the snaps, deep breaths, big words, deep breaths, big words, deep breaths, big words. Let the story speak for itself. Let the words breathe and live before they can't. Because back then I've attempted too many suicides on my language. I thought thoughts never existed until now. As I stand here not afraid, singing for the moment and feeling spectacular, having you all to thank for reminding me I can be assertive without the bass boost. Thank you for reminding me I had a voice all this time, just didn't know how to use it.